Looking for a warm, sunny, affordable place to live while you work remotely from your laptop? Well, look no further because Croatia has officially become the third country in Europe to announce plans for a digital nomad visa. And in this video, I'll tell you who qualifies, when applications will open, and most importantly, what makes Croatia such a good digital nomad destination. Plus, I'll give you some insight into how much it costs to live there and compare the cost of living in Croatia with the United States, plus bonus, how you might be able to get free healthcare for a year if you move there. And welcome to Traveling with Kristen, your destination for learning how to work online and travel the world. Subscribe to check out my library of more than 300 videos and live streams to help you do just that. And now let's talk Croatia. Now, if you've listened to my podcast or seen my videos about the Barbados and Estonia digital nomad visas, you'll know that Croatia is not the first country to announce plans to attract remote workers. But Croatia's digital nomad visa program is interesting to me for a variety of reasons that I'm going to share with you right now. First of all, the idea for Croatia's digital nomad visa didn't come from the government, like it did in Georgia, Estonia, Barbados, and other countries. It apparently came from a fellow digital nomad from the Netherlands named Jan de Jong, who allegedly sent a message to Croatia's prime minister on LinkedIn, encouraging him to take a closer look at remote workers and what they could do for Croatia's economy and tourism. This means that Croatia's government has a digital nomad alongside them, working with them on developing this visa and advising them about the needs of digital nomads and how Croatia can step up to meet them. So when can you apply for Croatia's digital nomad visa program? Well, the program is in the final stages of development right now and should be available by the first quarter of 2021. The cost and the exact requirements to apply haven't been released at the time of recording this video, but suffice to say, it will probably be open to citizens of any country, and I expect that Croatia will try to compete with Georgia, which is offering free application fees to their remote work program, or Estonia, who's charging between 80 and 100 euros per application. So I expect that Croatia's digital nomad visa program will range from free to $100 to apply. Now, other countries have also had a minimum required or recommended monthly income threshold. So in Georgia's case, they are recommending that digital nomads have a monthly income of at least $2,000 per month before they apply for the visa, whereas Estonia is requiring proof of income of 3,504 euro per month, and Dubai has just announced a visa with a minimum threshold of 5,000 US dollars per month in income. I expect Croatia's will be in the lower range because of the low to moderate cost of living in Croatia that we're gonna talk about in the end of this video, but that is what you can expect so far. And the benefits, if you were to apply for this visa, the number one benefit is how long you'll be able to stay in Croatia. Croatia is a unique country because it's in the European Union, but it's not in the Schengen zone. And to date, foreigners have mostly been able to go to Croatia for up to 90 days at a time, whereas this visa will allow them to stay for up to 1 year. And apparently in the first 6 months, if you really like living in Croatia, you can apply for another 1 year extension. So that will greatly increase the amount of time that you can reside in Croatia, from 90 days to potentially up to 2 years. And Croatia is located in a really convenient area between Europe, the Middle East, and Africa. So that means that you can use Croatia as your home base and travel to other nearby countries for probably much less than you're used to doing from your home country, especially if you live outside of the EU. Authorities have been rumored to be considering things like tax incentives, digital nomads' property needs, and other things like healthcare in developing this visa. So stay tuned for more details on that. And one clinic in Dubrovnik called Glavik Medical Center has also announced that they will be offering free medical services for up to 1 year for anyone with the digital nomad visa. So lots of exciting things to come for sure. So things sound pretty good so far, but why specifically would you want to live in Croatia? Well, I have another video on the top destinations for digital nomads that you can check out in this card over here, and I'll link to it in the description below. But basically, digital nomads are looking for a few key factors in any destination. First and foremost, safety and security, as well as good infrastructure and internet speeds, a favorable climate, good co-working facilities and community, as well as access to amenities. And Croatia really checks the boxes on all of these factors. From a safety and security standpoint, it is a democratic republic with a pretty good track record on human rights. And before the COVID-19 pandemic, Croatia was actually ranked as a level 1 on the US State Department's risk level scale, which is their lowest risk. Of course, that has gone up a little bit. It's now at a level 3 because of the risk of COVID-19 transmission. But nevertheless, Croatia ranks only in 26th position out of 163 countries on the Global Peace Index. So it is quite a safe and secure country. Digital nomads in Croatia also love the country's fast internet speeds. According to speedtest.net, Croatia ranks 11th in the world for their internet speeds, with an average download speed of about 70 megabits per second. When it comes to co-working and community, there are at least 20 co-working spaces throughout the country listed on coworker.com, and the same Dutch digital nomad, Jan de Jong, has founded Croatia's first digital nomad association, which is focused specifically on strengthening the digital nomad community in Croatia. You'll also never get bored in Croatia because there's plenty to do. Whether you're into sailing and water sports, or just lounging on the beach, or exploring all of the historical sites, museums, and culture, Croatia kind of has it all. There are a plethora of bars, restaurants, cafes, co-working spaces, and when you need to balance out all of that working, socializing, playing, and nightlife with some downtime, Croatia is also a great place to relax.
Oh, this is what we're doing today. Nothing, nothing.
Great. Well, what do I win?
Nothing!
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
6.5 hours late.
Just gonna jump in the water.
Foreigners also love Croatia's mild Mediterranean climate with upwards of 250 days of sunshine per year. And although Croatia isn't specifically located in a blue zone, the Mediterranean diet and lifestyle has been linked by researchers to greater longevity. We've covered the basics of the digital nomad visa, as well as what there is to do in Croatia and what the country has to offer to digital nomads. But a big concern that you likely have is, what is the cost of living? And I have good news for you, because it's quite low in Croatia. However, there's a big range depending on how long you stay there. So digital nomads that travel faster will actually have a higher cost of living than an expat who is a foreigner who's living there long term. So the rule of thumb generally is, the longer you live in a country, the lower your cost of living can be. So if you're a digital nomad who's just passing through Croatia on a passport for 30, 60, 90 days, your cost of living will be significantly higher than if you're there on the digital nomad visa and you stay for 1, even 2 years. As an example, the average cost of living for a digital nomad, depending on how long you stay and which part of Croatia you're in, can range from $1,300 per month to upwards of $2,500 or even $3,000 a month. Meanwhile, the average cost of living for an expat is much lower. It's probably between $900 a month and $1,800 a month. and locals can live there for under $1,000 per month. According to the website Numveo, the cost of living in Croatia is more than 21% lower than it is in the United States. And rent prices in Croatia on average is up to 65% less than the US. For example, the median cost of a one bedroom in the US is $1,000 per month, a two bedroom, more than $1,300 per month. And if you live in a city or metropolitan area like Silicon Valley, or New York City, the median price of a one-bedroom apartment can easily be over $2,000 per month. So that's more than your entire monthly cost of living could be in Croatia. And the rent prices are just the beginning, because even your internet package, for example, that might cost you $60, $70, or $80 in the US could cost you only $25 or $30 in Croatia for the same download speed. So if you're a remote worker looking to lower your cost of living while living abroad or having a location-independent lifestyle, watch this space, because Croatia is quite an ideal digital nomad destination. And as I mentioned, it's geographically located in a central region where you can travel to other countries and continents quite easily. So a round trip ticket from Atlanta to Paris, for example, could cost you anywhere from $500 round trip up to $1,500. Meanwhile, a round trip ticket from Zagreb to Paris could cost you only $150. Are you considering applying for Croatia's digital nomad visa? Why or why not? Or are you considering a different country's remote work program? Let me know in the comments below and subscribe for more than 300 videos that teach you how to work online and travel the world.